Good day and welcome back. In this video, we are going to enter chapter 3, which is about dynamics. In this lesson, we will revise about the Newton's laws of motion and about the resultant force that caused the object to accelerate. First, let's do a quick through on the definition. Newton's first law of motion is related to the inertia of an object. It states that object will continue to rest or move in constant velocity when there is no external force. So what will happen when there is external force is explained by Newton's second law that the object will experience change in momentum. So the rate of change in momentum is proportional to the force applied. The force may be proportional to the rate of change of velocity if the mass of the object is constant. So this is something we have learned in SVM syllabus. So you will learn something new that the force may also proportional to the rate of change of mass when the speed of the particle is constant. And we will talk again about this later on. So lastly is the Newton's third law of motion, explained that there is action and reaction force between two bodies which has the same magnitude but in the opposite direction. Let's see our first example from trial paper of SMK Yuhua in 2021. So this is a frictionless pulley system. To solve these kind of questions, we need to learn how to identify the force and sketch the free body diagram to have better understanding on the questions. So both the block has mass, so they have gravitational force or the weight that acting in downward directions. There will be also tension in the string which is trying to pull the mass out. So observe this question. What you can expect is that the heavier block N, which is 20 kg, will pull the block M up while moving down. To solve this question, let's define the equations based on each of the block. First is the block M. So the tension in the string is pulling the M up. So we have T minus the Mg is equal to 10A. And then for block N, since it is moving down, so we have the weight of the block N minus the tension is equal to 28. So here what you're going to do is to perform the simultaneous. So we can add both of the equations and you should be able to obtain the acceleration is equal to 3.3 meter per second squared. So substitute back the value of the acceleration into one of the equations above. You also can obtain the value of the tension in the string, which is 130.8 Newton. So this is how you can solve the questions by considering the force on each individual block. So now, observe the equations. Actually, you can ignore the tension and do the overall calculations. It is the pulling force, which is by the heavier object, minus the opposing force, which is by the lighter object. You can imagine like both of them are trying to pull each other up, but in the end, heavy object will pull the lighter object up while the heavy object is moving down as explained just now. So through this observation, can straight away define the equations without the tension that the pulling force minus all the opposing force. Here we have the weight of N minus the weight of M is equal to the total mass multiplied the acceleration. Now we look at second example from trial paper of Johor in 2021. Here we have three blocks connected by a string. So the question is kind enough that it already labeled all the tension in the string. From here, we can observe the phenomenon of Newton's third law of motion. For example, the tension between first and second block, which is also the pulling force. The 1 kg mass is pulling the 2 kg mass to the left, while the 2 kg mass also pulling the 1 kg mass to the right. So both tension here will have the same magnitude, but in the opposite direction. Let's continue to solve the question. We can straight away apply the second method mentioned just now, where we ignore the tension first to obtain the acceleration of the overall system. Here we only have the 12 Newton force pulling to the right. So substitute in the formula of F is equal to ma, we can calculate the acceleration is equal to 2 meter per second squared. Now, to obtain the tension, we now require to solve it based on each individual block. For the first block on the left, it is subjected to tension T2, which is labeled in the questions. Here, apply the formula of F is equal to ma, and you can obtain the tension T2 is equal to 2 Newton. Then we move on to the second block. It is subjected to the tension from the first mass and also from the third mass. We know it is moving to the right, so the equation will be T1 minus T2 equal to the mass 2 kg multiplied the acceleration 2 meter per second squared. Solving this equation will give us the tension T1 is equal to 6 Newton. Lastly, the third block that we have the equations of F minus T1 is equal to 3A. If we put in all the values of 10, the left-hand side of the equation should be equal to the right-hand side. So beside the tension in the string, there is also another case where the blocks are stick to each other. Observe this modified version of the question. It is actually similar except that the blocks are not connected through the pulling force or the tension in the string, but the pushing force between each of the blocks. Here, the 1 kg mass is pushed by the 12 Newton force, and it is pushing the 2 kg mass to the right while experiencing the reaction force also from that 2 kg. At the same time, There's also pushing force and the reaction force between the 2 kilogram and the 3 kilogram mass. So the phenomenon here also related to the Newton's third law of motions, and the solution is quite similar as the previous question. So I'll leave the solution here for you to do your own self-study. And now, let's see the case where the mass of object is not constant. There's one good example from the trial paper prepared by Sinkos Tan in 2021. You can have a look on the question here. The total mass of rocket is 56,000 kg and it ejects fuel gas at the rate of 125 kg per second. You are given with the acceleration of 8.3 meters per second, but notice that it specifies the value of the acceleration is at a time of 6.5 minutes or 390 seconds. So before we solve this question, let's see the free body diagram of the rocket. It has mass, so there's gravitational force acting in downward direction. There is outward force provided by the fuel, which is proportional to the rate of fuel gas ejected. So we have the formula of outward force is equal to V dm dt, where the speed of the rocket is assumed constant in this case. If we build the equation of F is equal to ma, we will have V dm dt minus the mg of the object equal to ma. Here you can take note on the equations. The velocity and the g are constant variable in this case, and the mass of the rocket is decreasing over the time. So we could deduce that acceleration of the object is not constant all the time. So this could be something you can think about it for a moment, but let's try to solve for the mass. We know that the total mass given, which is 56,000 kg, is the initial mass, and it is decreasing at the rate of 125 kg per second. So the mass at a certain time can be calculated by using the equation of m0 minus the rate of change of mass multiplied the time. So put in the value given in the question, we can obtain the mass of the rocket at the time of 6.5 minutes is 7,250 kg. And we can put in the value into the formula defined just now, and we can get the value of velocity is equal to 1,050 meters per second. So to discuss about the acceleration, let's see the initial condition. We still use the same formula, but we substitute in all the initial conditions to find out the acceleration of the object. We will find that the acceleration is equal to negative 7.5 meters per second squared. So if you have watched how the rocket is launched before, it doesn't go up in the first second, but actually took some time to be launched. Of course, it is actually far more complex to understand the working principle of the rocket launching, but do forgive me, it is out of the scope and out of my ability to explain it in details. So the conclusion I want to make here is that the acceleration of the motion will be fixed when the force is proportional to the rate of change of mass. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.